Belakor is the first true servant of the Dark Gods. His fell deeds have shaped mankind's history and subjected the mortal realms to the cruelty of his dominion. So hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to be taking you through a step-by-step guide on how to paint the Dark Master Belakor himself. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've used Chaos Black, which is perfect for all the colours on the base, as well as Belakor himself. Now, you'll notice as well, I've separated the base from the model. This just makes it easier to do the base later on. I've not glued it, I'll just tack it on because you've got some nice little locating slots for that as well. However, when you are dry brushing it, it's just worth having your thumb on his foot just so he doesn't wobble too much. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start dry brushing the skin, the wings, and all the other bits of membrane in between that as well. Now, I'll be using Skaven Blight Dinge for that. So what I'm going to do is get myself a large dry brush for this. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be going over a couple of areas like the chest, the inside of the wings, and the outside of the wings as well. Now, when doing any kind of dry brushing, what you need to do is just swirl it around like so, circular motions, crisscross motions, and the idea is to try and remove as much pigment as we can from the bristles. Now, you have to do this quite a few times when you're doing the model just to get a nice smooth coverage. So we'll start on the chest first, like so, and as you can see, just going up and down, slowly starting to pick out all that muscle on his body. Just take your time, like I say, you won't always do this on the first pass, you might have to just build it up slowly, work your way across his face. Now for the inside of the wings up here on the top, you can just use this big brush like so because you've got quite a lot of skeletal work there that you can work on. However, the membrane, I'm just going to move to a smaller brush because there's a lot of chains in the way as well. So I'm just going to flick up and down. This part's quite easy to get to, like so. However, I'm just going to have to go underneath, and using a smaller brush is going to give you a bit better access. So take your time and just slowly build those colours up. There we are, the inside of the wing membrane done. We're just going to spin it around now to do the outside. Very similar, you just don't have a lot of chains in the way. What you're aiming to do here is just slowly build up those ridges, going back and forth like so. So just nice gentle strokes like that. And again, just keep going back for more pigment if you need it. But I always recommend just up and down, because if you start going sideways, it's actually going to start going to those recesses. There we are, the back of the wings now dry brushed. What we're now going to do is move on to our next colours. So first of all, we'll use Storm Vermin Fur. Again, we're going to dry brush this over the wing membrane. We're going to do it on the chest as well as the horns. Then we'll use the same colour to layer some details, like the actual spiky horn bits on his wings, as well as his chest, cheeks and brow. Then after that, we'll use a Carrick Stone, again for a dry brush, over some areas very lightly. Then we'll also use that as edge highlighting as well, again around face details and the chest. But first of all, let's start with Storm Vermin Fur. So what I'm going to do, as I did before, is just get a little bit on the palette, circular motions like so, crisscross it back and forth like that. Again, trying to remove as much pigment as we possibly can. Now I'm using a smaller brush for this because obviously we don't want to go too mad and coat over the whole model. We're just keeping it to certain areas. So once I'm happy with that, just do a little bit more. There we are. And then ready to start dry brushing. I think I'll start on the wings. So we'll turn around, start on the back of the wings. And all I'm going to do, again as before, just gently back and forth like that. And it'll start to pick out that colour. And again, you might want to just build this up slowly over a couple of layers of dry brushing. There we are, that Storm Vermin Fur dry brush done. We're now going to use it as a layer, and we're just going to concentrate on some of the horns and spikes, especially around where his wings are, to get a bit more of a nice solid colour. There we are, with those spikes and horns now layered with Storm Vermin Fur. We're going to use Carrick Stone. I'm going to just gently dry brush around those areas as well, picking out those edges like so. And also we're going to go down onto the horns on his head as well, do those two. Just concentrate in the middle because we want it to look a little bit darker on the tips. And any other spikes or nails or like claws that you can see, just do a gentle dry brush with Carrick Stone as well. There we are, the dry brush now done. All I'm now going to do is use Carrick Stone just to pick out some like little highlights here and there on those areas we've been dry brushing. So I'm just going to add a little couple of dots just for a bit more definition on those horns. I'm going to do it on his teeth, also the spikes here. I'm just going to draw a little line just for a bit more definition so it's smoother and a little bit more crisper. The dry brush is going to do a lot for you, but actually in some places you just want a bit more of a harder edge. And there we are with those highlights of Carrick Stone now done. What we're now going to do is apply the last few colours to Bellicor's skin and wings. So what we're going to be doing first is using contrast medium mixed with Volupus pink. This is going to go into all like the recesses like the scars and also some of the areas on the wing membrane as well. And after that we're going to use Administratum grey to do some highlighting on his chest and also his limbs like his arms and his legs. Then after that we're going to use some Abaddon black which we're going to thin down just with water, and then we're just going to apply some of those deeper recesses just to add a bit more depth and a bit more punch to some of the black areas. But first of all, let's start with our contrast medium mix. So what I'm going to do here is get two paintbrushes worth of contrast medium, so two parts to one part Volupus pink. There's one paintbrush of Volupus pink there, mix it together. So it's not too neat from the pot, it's just a little bit more thinned down. I just need to make sure I get a nice point to my brush. Don't want to overload it too much. And what we're going to do here is I'll start on his chest because you've got his big eight-pointed star. So I'm just going to start running that in like so. Just add a bit of a purpley pink hue to it. And then some other areas you can concentrate on are things like around the spikes on his wings. So just run that in there like that. Again, it just gives it a bit more of a pinky purpley hue. And also around the skeletal work and the wing membrane as well. And again, if you're not sure, just check the box art for details. There we are with the Volupus pink mix now applied into all those recesses as well as the scars. What we're now going to do is move on to highlighting some of the areas using a little bit of Administratum grey. So what I'm going to do is to start working my way around some of the muscle areas. You've also got areas like the scale bits on the thighs as well and the arms, so pick those out too. Just take your time. Just a little bit of a highlight here and there. You don't have to go mad. Now that the Administratum grey has been highlighted, what we're now going to do is just finish off the skin by using a little bit of thinned down Abaddon black. What we're aiming to do here is just tidy up or add a little bit of depth to some of those deeper areas or areas like the knees like so. So in like some of the little bits of muscle here, just kind of a little bit. Because in some places the dry brush might have gone over this and knocked some of that depth out. And especially around the horns as well. So we're wanting the horns to go dark to light to dark again. So sitting around his head here, I'm just going to add a little bit of Abaddon black into those recesses. And there we are, the Abaddon black now applied to the recesses of Bellicor's skin. What we're now going to do is move on to his base. We're going to be doing some dry brushing here. We're going to start first with Storm Vermin Fur, then we're going to move to Carrick Stone, then we'll finish off with a little bit of Rakar Flesh. But first of all, let's start with that first colour. So we've got Storm Vermin Fur here, so I'm just going to load my brush up. As we've done with the previous dry brush, just going to do some circular motions like so, crisscross it as well. And again, we're aiming to get as much of that pigment off the brush as possible. So I'm just going to move to the side a little bit. Like so. Once I'm happy, I'm now just going to take Bellicor off his base because I've not glued him on because I don't want to get all that actually on that skin we spent ages dry brushing. And then all we're going to now do is start picking that out on the actual rock like so. So just take your time and try and keep it to those raised details. There we are, the dry brush of Storm Vermin Fur now done. We're going to get some Carrick Stone. We're just going to start lightly dry brushing that around the rock as well. Basically just tickling it so you're not putting too much pressure on. Just touching the edges like so. There we are, the Carrick Stone done. We're now just going to use a little bit of Rakar Flesh just on the edges of the steps and on the tips of the rock as well, just add a little bit more definition. There we are, the stone on the base now dry brush. What we're now going to do is move on to the next area, which is the molten lava on the base. We're going to start first by using Corn Red, which will thin down just to make it easy to get into those crevices and cracks. Then we're going to use some Flesh Tearer's Red just to make it a little bit dark and add a bit of richness to that red. Then on the raised areas, we're going to highlight back up using a little bit of Corn Red, followed by Wild Rider Red, and then finish off with a little dot here and there of Bestigor Flesh. But first of all, let's start off with Corn Red. So all I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops onto my palette and a little bit of water. In fact, I'll add a little bit more because I want it a little bit more runny this time around. The key thing is make sure you get a brush to a nice point. For this, I'm using a medium layer brush. And all we're going to do is start hunting for those little cracks and crevices and then just start applying the Corn Red in there. If you do find you get some on the edges where you've dry brushed up, just get some of that colour from the previous dry brushes and just do a little bit of a tidy up stage of dry brushing up. With the Corn Red now applied to the molten lava and the crevices and cracks, we're now going to use a little bit of Flesh Tearer's Red, just add a bit of depth to that Corn Red. And also, because it's a little bit more runny, being a contrast paint, in some places where you couldn't quite get to your brush, it's just going to run in there and add a little bit of a red tone. Again, if you do make mistakes like I've just done there, either wipe with your finger quickly or just add a bit more of a dry brush on those raised areas once the Flesh Tearer's Red is dry. There we are. The flesh tear is red now dry. What we're now going to do is just tidy up some of those raised areas, just add a bit more punch to that dark red by using corn red again and just layering up like so. Don't have to go mad, just a few bits here and there where it's obviously like just pouring out and you've got some nice little dribbles going on there. Now that we've tied up with corn red, what we're now going to do is use some Wild Rider red to make some of this molten lava feel a little bit more vibrant. So I'm just going to start at the bottom here and I'm just layering up some of these dribbles, if you like, as they're pouring out. Some of the deeper cracks, you might just want to do like the odd little line here and there, but don't go too mad. And remember, as always, if you make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up with those dry brushes. Now that we've applied the Wild Rider red, all we're going to now do is use a little bit of Besticore flesh, just add a little bit of punch to that molten lava, make it feel like it's glowing slightly. There we are, with the Besticore flesh now applied as a final highlight, we're ready to move on to the next step. You'll also notice I've reattached Bellicore to the base as well. So what I'm going to do now is move on to the metallics. So I'm going to start first by using Iron Hand Steel, which is going to be for the silver details. After that, we're going to move on to Retributor Armor for any gold details such as trim. Then we're going to use Basilicane and Grey and coat that over all the metallics. Once that's dry, we're going to thin down some Skeleton Horde with a little bit of Contrast Medium. And this is going to go on the silver just to make it feel a little bit old and tarnished. Then once that's dry, we're then going to highlight both the metallics using the same colour, which will be Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with Iron Hand Steel. So I'm going to use my medium layer brush again for this. So I'm going to apply a little bit to the palette, as we always do, and add a little bit of water. Now, normally, I'd only add a little bit, but I'm just going to thin this down a little bit more because it's going to make it a lot easier for it to go into all those like nooks and crannies of the links on those chains. So you probably want to do a couple of coats here. So I'm going to concentrate on the wing to start off with. So you've got the little ringlet here. So I'm just going to pick that out. Take my time. With the Iron Hand Steel being a little bit more thinned down, you'll just notice it will just drop into those recesses a lot easier. Like I said, on some of the raised areas, you might just need to do a second coat. But for most of the chains, just thinning it down a little bit more will just make your life much easier. There we are, with all those silver details like the chains picked out, we're now going to move on to the gold. And for this, we're going to start with Retributor Armor. So I'm going to be just picking out things like the shoulder pad trim. This is also on his greave and also his van brace. And then you got like some crown scattered across the chains and also the hilt and pommel of his sword. There we are, with all those gold details now picked out, what we're now going to do is get Basilicane and Grey and we're just going to apply that over both the silver and the gold details. This is going to obviously darken down the silver a little and also really make that gold look old and tarnished as well. There we are. Now that our Basilicane and Grey is now dry, what we're now going to do is apply some Skeleton Horde that's been thinned down with Contrast Medium. We're applying this to the silver and this is three parts Contrast Medium to one part Skeleton Horde. And all we're aiming to do here is just change the tone of the actual armour on his thigh there, and you've got your shoulder pauldron here as well, and also his van brace. It's going to make it feel a little bit like old, tarnished metal. There we are, with that Skeleton Horde and Contrast mix now applied to that armour. We're now going to start highlighting all those silvers. So all I'm going to be doing here is using Stormhost Silver, working around the edges of things like the trim and the armour. Now when you get to things like the chains and stuff like that, like up here for instance, you can dry brush if you want to. All I'm going to do is just use the edge of the brush and just pick out those links. Like so, you can just do that all the way around, taking your time. If you've got rivets as well, you can always just dot those as well and just pick out the edges and just keep working your way along all the armour. With all those metallics now highlighted, what we're going to do now is move on to painting the skulls and bones on the model. Now we're going to start first by using Rakar flesh as a base coat. Once that's dry, we're then going to coat over all the skulls using Skeleton Horde. Then we're going to tidy back up just some of the raised areas, using a little bit more Rakar flesh again, then finish off with highlights just around the eye sockets, nose and teeth, using a little bit of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with Rakar flesh. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops, like so, a little bit of water, and again, putting too much just in case it dries out, and then just get my brush to a nice point like so. Then we're ready to start picking out all those skulls. I'm just going to start off on the center here where his loincloth is. So all I'm going to do is just coat over. In some places you might want to do a couple of thin coats just to build up that color. Just take your time. Now there's quite a lot of skulls to pick out, so just sit down and enjoy it. There we are, the skulls base coated in Rakar flesh. What we're going to do now is just coat over all the skulls and any other little bones that are scattered across the base using Skeleton Horde. Now that the skeleton horde's dry, all we can now do is use Rakov flesh again to start picking out some of those raised areas. So what you're basically doing here is just layering back over and leaving that skeleton horde in the recesses. There we are, with all those skulls now tied up with Rakov flesh, we're now going to start highlighting with Screaming Skull. Just going to keep it to things like the cheekbones, around the eye sockets, teeth and nose. So I'm not going to go too mad. With all those skulls now highlighted, what we're now going to do is move on to picking out the loincloth and the weapon handle. Now I'm going to start first by base coating both these details by using Barrack Gnar Burgundy. Then after that we'll use Basilican and Grey, which will coat all over. Then on the loincloth we're going to tidy back up with a little bit of Barrack Gnar Burgundy again. Then we're going to move on to highlighting with Pink Horror. And just on the loincloth to make it feel like torn old leather, we'll be using a little bit of Carrick Stone. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So all I'm going to do here is just get some of my Barrack Gnar Burgundy on the palette, a little bit of water, get a good point to the brush, and then we're ready to start base coating. Like I said, I'm just going to start with the actual loincloth. Just take my time. I want to do a couple of thin coats, and also don't forget that weapon handle as well. With the loincloth now base coated, what we're now going to do is get some Basilican and Grey, and we're just going to start applying that all over. So most of that's going to sink into the recesses. It's also going to change the tone, a little of the actual Barrack Gnar Burgundy as well. Now that the Basilican and Grey is dry, what we're going to do now is just tidy back up some of those raised areas using Barrack Gnar Burgundy. So again, you're trying to keep all the folds of cloth that are higher up, whilst leaving some of the ones in the deeper areas a little bit darker. With those areas now tidied up, what we're now going to do is use Pink Horror and start highlighting the cloths. So I'm just going to work my way around the top and start going down the bottom. Again, you want a fairly thick highlight here, just in some places, because we'll be using Carrick Stone after. With our Pink Horror highlight now done, what we're now going to do is use a little bit of Carrick Stone just to make this leather feel a little bit more natural and torn and old. So I'm just going to get some Carrick Stone and just start applying that around the edges, doing little dots and like little flicks here and there to make it feel a bit aged and torn. With that Carrick Stone highlight now done, our loincloth is finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to the leather straps. So we're going to start first by using Mournfang Brown as the base coat. And once that's dry, we're going to apply Basilican and Grey all over. Then we're going to use Mournfang Brown again to tidy up, almost like layering and highlighting just on some of those raised details. Then finish off with a highlight of Carrick Stone. But first of all, let's start with Mournfang Brown. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops onto my palette. And then I'm just going to thin that down a little, get a good point to the brush, and then we're ready. I'm going to start first with the straps that are actually on the front of his loincloth. Just going to plop him back into his base there because he did pop out. So all we're going to now do is just start picking those out. Now there's lots of leather straps around the back of his armour as well. So where he's got his van braces, his shoulder pauldron, and the armour here, the greaves. You have to pick those out as well, like you can see just here. There's a couple of little straps. Just take your time, work your way around the model. Now that those leather straps have been picked out, what we're now going to do is use Basilican and Grey just to shade them down a bit. As you can see, I'm just going to coat that over all the straps, like so. With the Basilican and Grey now dry, what we're now going to do is get some Mournfang Brown and we're just going to start highlighting around the edges, like so, just to broaden it out a bit and add an extra level of colour. Now that we've tidied back up with Mournfang Brown, all we're now going to do is use some Carrick Stone. We're just going to apply that on the edges as a highlight, just to make it look a little bit torn. So just doing little dots like this. There we are, with those straps now done, what we're now going to do is move on to the Blade of Shadows for Bellicor. Now I'm going to start first by base coating with Incubine Darkness, then in some areas we're going to layer over with Cabalite Green. After that, we're going to start doing some highlights, starting first with Araman Blue, then following that with Temple Guard Blue, then we'll finish off with Barahoff Blue. Also, those later highlight colours we're also going to use for the eyes of Bellicor as well. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So I'm just going to get a little bit on the palette, a little bit of water, and then once we're happy, we're then going to start base coating it. What we're going to do is just take our time. Doesn't matter if you get on some of the smoke areas, because we'll be sorting that out in a bit. Now that we've base coated the blade of Incubine Darkness, what we're now going to do is use Cabalite Green, and we're going to kind of layer it in places and also edge highlight. So just around the base of the blade here, it's more of a layer. And as we start going further up the blade, it's going to be more of a highlight. We're also going to emphasize some of those areas where it's turning from blade to smoke. Now that we've laid up with Cabalite Green, we're now going to move on to some highlights. We're going to start first with Araman Blue. So what we're going to do is pick out the edges of the sword and some of the smoke details. We also want to start picking out the eyes as well of Bellicor. There we are with that highlight of Araman Blue now done. You'll also notice I picked out Bellicor's eyes as well. So what we're going to do now is use Temple Guard Blue. And we're just going to focus on the edge of the blade. Just take your time working your paintbrush around those edges. With that stage done, we're now going to finish off the blade by using a little bit of Barahoth Blue just for a nice fine edge highlight on the blade. We'll also do this on the eyes again as well. And in some of the deeper recesses of that smoke, I'm just going to drop some paint in there as well. Just give it a nice bit of a glow. With the blade of the Blade of Shadows now done, what we're now going to do is move on to the smoke. So we're going to start first by base coating the smoke with Skaven Blight Dinge. And after that, we're going to layer up some of the raised areas using a little bit of Storm Vermin Fur. Then in the recesses, we're going to get some Volupus Pink, mix that with Contrast Medium, and just run that into some of the recess to give it that kind of like pinky hue that you see on the box art. Then we're going to highlight back up with Administratum Grey, and then finish off with a dry brush on the tips of the smoke using a Baden Black. But first of all, let's start with Skaven Blight Dinge. So as before, just going to get a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water. And then once I've got a nice point to the brush, we're ready. So all I want to do is just get the flames like so and start base coating all the flames. Now in some places, you might want to just move a bit further down to where the blade is, especially when you can see some obvious flame detail moving onto the blade. So just carefully paint that in. Just work your way all around the smoke like so. Now that we've base coated the smoke with Skaven Blight Dinge, what we're now going to do is use Storm Vermin Fur to start highlighting and layering up some of those raised areas. So it's more of a layer at the very tips of the smoke, but as I get further down, I'm just going to start using the edge of the brush like so, just to make it more of a highlight. Now that we've layered up with Storm Vermin Fur, what we're now going to do is get some Contrast Medium and mix two parts Contrast Medium to one part Volupus Pink. I'm just going to run that into some of the recesses of the smoke. Just give it that bit of a pinky hue, as you see on the box art. And also, at this point, it's worth picking out just the bottoms of some of these hooks as well, because on the box art, they have a bit of a pinky hue to them as well. Now that we've applied that contrast mix, what we're now going to do is get some Administratum Grey and start doing some little highlights on the smoke. Now, I'm kind of keeping it to the middle areas of the smoke, so not too close to the base, not too close to the tips. Just take my time, just pick out those edges. Again, using the edge of your brush where possible. There we are, that highlight now done. What we're now going to do is use a Baden Black and just start dry brushing the tips of that smoke. Starting from the top and working our way down a little bit. Now that we've dry brushed a Baden Black onto that smoke, the sword is now finished. And also at this point, I've glued Bellicor to his base. So the last thing we're going to do is just finish the model by basing it. So I'm going to start first by applying some Astro Granite. We're going to do this all around the base. Once that's dry, we're going to use some Basilicanum Grey, which will coat all over. Then we're going to do some dry brushes, starting first with Storm Vermin Fur, and then moving on to Carrick Stone after. But first of all, let's start with our texture paint. So I'm going to get my trusty texture tool. It's going to get a large scoop of that onto the spatula. And then all we're going to do is then start applying that to the actual base itself. So first of all, I'm just going to apply a little bit around the edge like that, because I've got to be quite mindful not to get any on that lava. And all I'm now going to do is just use the smaller side to be a little bit more accurate and move that in. And again, once you've done that, I'm going to leave it for around about an hour to thoroughly dry. For that texture now dry, what we're now going to do is get some Basilicanum Grey and then start coating that over. Just to make it feel a little bit more natural, I'm going to start blending that in a little bit into the actual texture that's already on the base. Now that the Basilicanum Grey is dry, we're now going to start dry brushing using Storm Vermin Fur. So again, just taking our time, moving around, and I'm going to try and blend some of that into the existing texture of the base as well. Again, be mindful not to get it on the lava, and if you do, you might just have to tidy back up with those colours. Now that we've dry brushed with Storm Vermin Fur, we're going to finish the base off by dry brushing with Carrick Stone. And again, just matching some of that into the existing texture of the base. Once you've done that, all you need to do is paint the rim of the base in a colour scheme that matches your force. For this one, we're going to use Steel Legion Drab. And there we are, with the texture now dry and the rim painted, our base is now done. With the base finished, Bellacor is now ready to head off into both the 41st millennium and the Mortal Realms to create utter carnage and devastation. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlighting, remember to take your time and maintain a nice point to your brush, and also try and support your arms where possible. When doing any dry brushing, try and remove as much pigment from those bristles as possible, and remember, you're building those layers up gradually, so don't expect immediate results on the first pass. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Bellacor the Dark Master, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.